Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Here we have a view from the Old Faithful webcam. Looking there at the Upper Geyser Basin at Yellowstone National Park. Yeah. Those of you that have been following me know about the unzipping during the last major eruption of Yellowstone. How it started up here by the Madison River area, did a counterclockwise rotation until it got down here by Heart Lake. And then at that time, both resurgent domes collapsed at the same time, creating the huge eruption that everyone talks about. They don't talk about the 40 smaller eruptions, at least 40, that have happened since then. And then, you know, I was thinking about the resurgent domes collapsing at the same time, and the crack, the fault line that they have there at Yellowstone Lake, where there's dike intrusion trying to come up. It's got a cap of rhyolite holding all that magma down. So I was wondering if during the last eruption, when the two resurgent domes collapsed, creating that huge eruption that changed the weather pattern of the Earth for decades, put us in an ice age, would there be a sign prior to the collapse of the eruption of magma there at Yellowstone? Or would this area just become a giant eruption of flames and lava and magma bombs coming out of it? USGS is reporting 30 earthquakes within the last week on this map. One up here, which we probably couldn't add into it, by Gardner, and another one down here by Kelly, Wyoming. They have not reported any earthquakes for the Yellowstone area within the last 24 hours, even though we know that there's been earthquakes. Here we have the thumbnails, and I've talked about the volcano screaming. Well, we got indications of that here at Mirror Lake Plateau. Look at all of them in red. And let me go up here. Is this Soda Butte up here? There's Soda Butte. And Norris Junction. Yeah, we got drum beats. The most significant, of course, is Little West Thumb. That's where the crack is at. I call it Little West Thumb. They just call it West Thumb. But years ago, it used to be called Little West Thumb. I don't know why. Anyways, and then let's come down here. The western boundary. Okay, yeah, see, we got drum beats and some small earthquakes here. Maple Creek is also showing signs of this screaming of the volcano. Purple Mountain also had drum beats. Pelican Cone over here on the eastern side, yeah, drum beats. And I don't know if you can see those little triangles right there. Yep, that's where it was screaming. And yeah, see how wide that is, that space there. Yellowstone has been recharging for another eruption for about 6,000 years. It's a huge volcano, so big it's actually got two resurgent domes compared to one. Here we have the Mallard Lake resurgent dome that we can see here on the live web camera. This here is Old Faithful. I have never seen the activity that I have seen in the last month at Yellowstone, with the screaming of the magma coming in. Like I said, Yellowstone has 40 smaller eruptions since its last major eruption. And I believe it's going to have another eruption. Who knows when? I don't know when. Hopefully it's going to be a smaller one. But all the indications showing that it is recharging for an eruption. And like I said, I hope it's a small one. I normally only download data from three different monitors to save on space so you guys can see. But I downloaded four today. on the left is the western boundary here. The one next to it is Little West Thumb. Yeah, look at that. We got Denny Creek and the borehole. This is a very deep well, probably 600 feet under the surface for the Madison River area. Madison River was showing what I described yesterday as the blobs of magma. That's their actual scientific term. When the blobs, thick magma decides to come into the system all at once. Someone talked about the old Steve McQueen movie back, what was it, in the 50s, called The Blob, that was invading the town and gobbling up movie theaters and stuff like that. I showed you in my last Yellowstone video about how volcanoes actually do scream. It's kind of like emitting a tea kettle-like screech prior to an eruption. This was on Smithsonian Magazine. Wired Magazine also had an article about volcanoes screaming before they erupt. I've talked about, too, about how, because Yellowstone's got that cap of rhyolite, one of the most explosive types of magma you can possibly have anywhere in the world, holding the magma down, that the magma was moving horizontally, moving out sideways. Here they're talking about the blobs of magma. It appears to be caused by something deep within the earth moving sideways, almost like rats running underneath a carpet, said the study author Brian Lovell of the University of Cambridge. The hot blob would spread out from the center of the hot spot, rather like a donut. Catch that? The hot spot. And it goes into about the hot spot there beneath Iceland. Another article from 2015 from Live Science. Titanic blob of magma. Yeah, that's their actual scientific term. Found beneath Yellowstone supervolcano. A giant-shaped reservoir of shearing hot rock has been discovered far below the supervolcano underneath Yellowstone Park, one that could fill the Grand Canyon more than 11 times over, researchers say. Remember that, you guys? So this thick, ooey-gooey blobs of magma comes up. It melts the rock a little bit, and then it pauses until pressure builds, and then it pushes up a little bit higher, creating the drum beats. Now, this here is the borehole for the Madison River area. And they got a couple earthquakes marked in red here. Now, this here, a circle I've shown you before, is identified as tectonic plate movement. And let's pull this, because we have both tectonic plate movement, and we also have, right there, let's grab that, volcanic tremors. Here's a document about volcanic tremors, how you see them prior to an eruption. Sometimes you see them during an eruption, around where the magma is coming up. This article has them about an eruption there in Japan, and the one in Hawaii, Kilauea. They are supposed to be recorded between 1 and 10 hertz. So here on the side, we got hertz. We got 5 and 10, and you can see all this activity over here. Let's pull this over. This is the spectrogram showing you the line of melt. And we'll just jump around here to some of these. Oops, went off. I wanted to go here. Yeah, to some of these that are marked in red. Yeah, you notice the heavier of the line is between, of the magma, is between 1 and 10 hertz over here. Something new for everyone to learn. Let's go over here to this one that's marked in red. There you go. Let's pull this over. Oh, went off the line, sorry. And we'll go to this one. Yeah, Yellowstone is definitely gearing up for another eruption. I don't know when. It's a huge volcano. I don't know how much magma has to come up. They don't tell us currently, right now, what percentage of melt we have. They say that you wouldn't have to worry about an eruption unless it gets to be about 35-33% melt. I do know that there is pockets of melt only 600 feet below where people walk, and that would account for people's shoes melting, roads melting, things like that. Here we have a image of them taking a thermal reading from one of the boardwalks where the magma was rising up. They had to close it down because of the heat coming up under the ground. And you can see the discoloration here on this path. We got one here. We got another one there. And yeah, over here, you can see all the dead trees too within this area. I mean, look at them. And they were killed by the gases coming up. There was actual areas. Well, you can see on the live webcam another area such as this where the magma was coming up and actually melted the road, and they had to block this off. They had to raise the roads, rip out all the asphalt, raise the roads, put a bed of gravel underneath, hoping that it would dissipate the heat that was coming up, and then repave the roads. That's an ongoing process that they're always doing there. Now, once again, this is the data from the borehole at the Madison River area. This is where originally the unzipping started, went counterclockwise before its last major eruption. Little West Thumb. That's what I call it. I want to be picky about it. Some people like to be picky. It's called West Thumb there at Yellowstone Lake. All the screaming that's going on, it gets so loud that sometimes the data cannot be recorded. Yeah, look at that. And it went on for how many hours? Let's take a look. At least 10 hours. And let's go down here. Let's see. Let me pull it up. There we go. Pull it up. Yeah, there's nothing to worry about, is there? Absolutely nothing. Right. Frequency hertz between 0, or 1, I should say, and 10. So way down here at the bottom would be 0. And it goes all the way up to 10.6 hertz. This is not stampeding buffalo. Cars going over speed bumps. Road construction. Anything like that. Denny Creek. The most recent, let's go down there first. The most recent when I pulled the files a little while ago is right here. Look at that. Okay, and look at the hertz. Look at the magma that came up. I am telling you things that they do not want you to know. Well, maybe they're hoping it'll be a small eruption, and just like Iceland, they'll get all the tourists that come in and play volleyball as the magma flows. You know, there is a chance it could just be basalt and not a rhyolite explosion. This here is Denny Creek's monitor. And yeah, look at that. We'll just click on some of these. I have never seen any signature at Yellowstone. This is the first day for this signature that I've seen. Yeah, today is August 25th, 2022. This is the first time I've seen signatures like this at the park. At any time, that weird little, let's go back to it, that weird little, see that? That's where the ground gets so brittle that the magma is finding a conduit to come up, putting pressure on the ground. Let's try and extract that and see what we get. All right, we got a thickening of the lines here. I'll have to make that larger for you. more blobs of magma. Now, this is tectonic plate movement as the North American plate slowly moves going southwest. And see that by the sharp points. And then I want to go to these recent small earthquakes that they say did not happen. That's the most recent one at 1427. That's universal time, which would be at 9:27 a.m. It's little. It's very small. That one comes in as a magnitude 1.02. And then we got another one right there. Looks like a series of popping there. And then we got another one there. Let's look at the spectrogram. Another small one. Here we have little West Thumb, when I pulled the files. You can see that's where I ended it at. And yeah, it's screaming so loud it couldn't pick up the signature. Was beyond the capability of the equipment. And yeah, what else we got here when I pulled the files? Let's try this one right here. 5:36 universal time. So that would be 12:36 a.m. today. Let me go over here, see what that is. See what else we got here. Yep. Pulled it up, and then we got that there. Look how long that lasted. That was at 11:08 p.m. last night. Where is it at? Up over here. Let's go to its signature. I'll pull it back over for you. Doesn't really look as dirty today as it did in my last video. The railroad is going to be going on strike. I got word from my daughter. She works with a woman whose son works for the railroad, and he told her to better stock up because there's going to be shortages of good. 1/3 of all our goods come by railroad. So if you're not prepping for, you know, volcanic eruptions or earthquakes or floods, prep because of the shortages that are going to be coming because of the railroad strike. Anyways, what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.